Στο σημείο αυτό θέλω να προσκαλέσω στο βήμα τον κύριο Χριστόπουλο, Ναύαρχο του Πολεμικού Ναυτικού, να μας πει δύο λόγια. Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Good morning again, then. I'm Rear Admiral George Christopoulos, member of the Admiral's Board of the Hellenic Navy. On behalf of the Hellenic Navy, my very warm welcome to this year's ASRAE International Conference in Athens. Engineers, scientists, members of the ASRAE once again come together for discussions over proven technology aspects, state-of-the-art solutions, contemporary designs which advance the arts and sciences of energy. It is an honor and a privilege to be awarded to address a so distinguished audience, especially when I'm appointed to represent a new partner of the ASRAE, the Hellenic Navy. Hellenic Navy is delighted to implementing for a year now a working relationship with the ASRAE Hellenic Chapter. The scope of our cooperation is to exchange technical expertise and knowledge transferring in the widest spectrum possible and in a continuous manner. The Hellenic Navy is vested with the defense of our country's area of sovereign rights by exercising maritime interdiction and sea control in times of crisis or war. The motto of the Hellenic Navy is Mega to the Salasis Kratos, from Thucydides' account of Pericles' oration in the eve of the Peloponnesian War. This has been roughly translated as the rule of the sea is a great matter, or as great is the country that controls the sea. The Hellenic Navy force structure is tailored to the particularities of the operational environment in the Aegean and the Eastern Mediterranean, providing our forces with the means to project power to the area of strategic interest, to conduct maritime security operations, to support state diplomacy, and finally, to operate with allies and partners. Furthermore, a specific challenge currently draws our attention. This is the security of energy supply lanes and other seabed sources, which is nowadays valued by taking into account the interest of international corporations in possible fossil fuel reserves in western and southern sea blocks. The 62 combat surface, subsurface ships and the 19 air assets of the Hellenic Navy make it a credible security provider in Eastern Mediterranean and the naval force capable of supporting state interests beyond our region, if this is necessary. Hellenic Navy combatants are the key elements in our current and future naval force. Our combatants have set standards in naval operations and are still front runners due to their state-of-the-art platform, sensor, and weapon systems. They depict a compromise-free multifunction capability for intense usage, superior in all waters and for any mission. The inherent challenges are driven by operations in potentially hostile and littoral waters, along with extreme environmental conditions, most of the time for an extended period. These ships represent an incredible technological asset for our country. And in order to maintain the so many advantages of the existing warships types and designs, an extensive procurement support and modernization program is in a continuous action, although the defense budget is in competition with other priorities nowadays. Despite the difficult times, the service is looking forward to inducting new assets into the fleet. Three new 214 type submarines and three Super Vita fast attack crafts are about to be commissioned the coming 2 years. Meanwhile, the Navy's most important procurement program is the acquisition of new multi-purpose frigates and the fast-tracking of mid-life upgrade of the 4 MECO-type frigates together with the modernization of the 5 maritime patrol aircrafts. Strategic and operational planning, as well as available financial resources, will certainly outline the criteria for our future modernization and replacement programs. The goal is to ensure a proper composition of the Hellenic Navy for structure. Today, more than ever, Hellenic Navy is called to innovate and implement new technologies to effectively meet the ever-changing challenges of the international and domestic environment. As our operational commitments remain high, we seek to invent new ways to achieve our mission with fewer resources. We encourage and support the design, development and fielding of innovative technologies in cooperation with our partners like ASRAE and institutions of the public and private sector. There are still significant levels of capability improvement on the drawing board for our combatants, with technical and financial risks in doing so, and we are keen to take this opportunity to understand how our new partners in ASRAE technology forums have met similar challenges. At this point, I want to highlight the good level of cooperation we have established with ASRAE Hellenic Chapter. The cooperation with ASRAE involves a variety of activities on the academic, technology transfer, maintenance and technical support fields, but I will choose to stress the cooperation we are building in the context of the naval dimension of the environment and energy conservation aspects. This relation will be further enhanced by co-organizing with ASRAE Hellenic Chapter and the Technical Chamber of Greece, International Conference, Environment and Energy in Ships, in Athens again, on May 22nd to 24th next year. The conference seeks to bring together the various professionals involved in the shipping industry, both onshore and at sea, and to present the current state of the art and insight in future technologies and challenges related to energy efficiency, indoor environmental quality, energy safety and security. The conference will provide a comprehensive overview of the areas relevant to military and commercial ships. Together with ASRAE Hellenic Chapter and the Technical Chamber of Greece, we are intended to lay this challenge before this conference so that we may all better understand the opportunities and issues in managing energy and systems in increasingly constrained resource environments, where the risk of operating hardware up to and sometimes beyond their design limits requires our best intellectual and technical abilities. I believe that each engineer here has already confronted with a similar set of challenges, and when we are prepared to share those, we all benefit messages. The interactive processes of our collaboration are an opportunity to learn from each other, and by the way, to get to know another better. We shall utilize every opportunity to share our operational and technical experiences and to grow wisdom and friendships through cooperation and shared values. Energy management, whether in an urban or industrial environment, requires a collective effort and commitment from all involved disciplines. The same applies for seaport energy systems. Only the application of inspired design and demanding building standards will compromise maximum effectiveness. Hellenic Navy expectation for the cooperation with ASRAE is to establish an open, continuous, constructive and fruitful dialogue so that everyone participating in this process will gain valuable information and draw their benefit from attending. I strongly believe that the ASRAE activities provide a unique platform for naval officers and civilian engineers and scientists to exchange views, experience and facilitate a sound vision for future intense cooperation. Dear guests, concluding my brief presentation, I would like to assure you that the Hellenic Navy, with its modern assets and the well-trained personnel as its force multiplier, remains a primary security provider in Eastern Mediterranean. We stand ready to contribute whenever and wherever needed to the collective effort for stability, security and peace, along with the protection of our national integrity and interests. Furthermore, we are well aware that the Hellenic Navy will face more challenges in the year ahead, and that tough decisions and even compromises will have to be made. Ladies and gentlemen, this conference and the coming one is yet another opportunity to add value to the fine concept of cooperation. And I hope all participants find these meetings meaningful and relevant for the future, and that sharing experience and technical knowledge will open new opportunities to explore. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you. And I will ask for a few minutes, 3 minutes actually from your time, to project a video clip that links the recent history of Hellenic Navy and its present.